Purdue's aerial robotics team has developed a versatile UAS platform to perform an autonomous navigation and sensing mission that is representative of real-world deployments. Unfortunately, an array of complications caused the annulation of a custom and novel dual-boom design. Instead, a previous yet highly reliable platform will be used as a substitute airframe, but will still house the majority of newly developed electronics and onboard image processing algorithms. The team still predicts a high level of performance in its competition configuration.
A traditional aircraft configuration with high rectangular wing and an airfoil specifically designed for low Reynolds numbers allows us to achieve high lift and stability at slow speeds of approximately 13 meters per second. Utilizing additive manufacturing and carbon composite techniques, we are able to maximize our weight savings while retaining the strength and rigidity required for the mission.
The software subteam designed the autonomous algorithms for target detection, localization, and classification, built the graphical user interfaces for monitoring and manual annotation, and created the image stitching process. Our image processing algorithms are a blend of deep learning and classical techniques, all of which run on the NVIDIA Jetson Xavier NX. A GoPro Hero 10 capturing 23 megapixel images at 60 frames per second feeds our models on the UAS before the predictions are streamed down to our ground station for review and submission to the interop system.
The electrical sub-team was responsible for integrating the flight hardware, communication networks, and autonomy algorithms into the aircraft. The team's autonomous flight was achieved using modified RRT Dubin's paths. We tested the output of the mission software extensively in software simulation before attempting real flights on actual hardware. The flight controller was selected for its advanced count of sensors, easy integration with existing hardware, and support by the PX4 organization.
The team has ranked expected task performance on a qualitative scale ranging from a low to high level of confidence. Autonomous UAS functions, waypoint accuracy, and mission fail-safes are expected to be completed successfully. Heart is confident in stationary obstacle avoidance but will not attempt dynamic. All ODCL tasks are expected to be completed at high level except for geolocation. Mapping tasks will be completed during the mission's demonstration, and the UGV will not be attempted in Part's 2022 UAS design due to unexpected change in vehicle platforms. Purdue holds itself to a high standard of operational excellence and expects a safe mission for all.
The developmental testing phase allowed the aeromechanical, electrical, and software teams to collect data and make adjustments as necessary to fulfill the mission requirements through a three-phase testing plan. First, individual unit testing, followed by subsystem integration, and then a full-scale testing between the three teams. Each component manufactured in-house was tested thoroughly prior to installation within the subassembly to ensure adequate part quality and prove various factors of safety. Aircraft subassemblies were also tested to prove realistic flight conditions, and independent subsystems were assembled and integrated for full-scale testing. Aircraft integration testing began with the Bixler 3 foam platform, allowing safety pilots to manually fly while collecting data to adjust appropriate handling parameters for following autonomous flights. Additionally, this provided useful information to the aeromechanical team regarding stability and handling, which prompted minor modifications to the airframe prior to full-scale testing. Full-scale testing of the 2022 competition aircraft consisted of a step-by-step systematic approach to introducing new features of the mission requirements, allowing for individual problems to be isolated and debugged prior to introducing new variables. The 2021-22 flight testing season included a total of 45 flights, consisting of 15 manual, 18 hybrid, and 12 fully autonomous flights, allowing for more than 12 flight hours of data to be recorded and analyzed for further improvement. Additionally, the aircraft was tested in winds excess of 15 knots and gusts greater than 20 knots, with no additional concerns regarding temperature, precipitation, or visibility.
PART used a four-step process in tuning the competition system. First, the aircraft parameters, flight dynamics, and autopilot system were tested in virtual environments. This provided a safe and time-efficient way to iterate through design changes. From there, the aircraft was carefully flown in an experimental setup, allowing for a qualitative evaluation of the features being tuned. Next, data logs were analyzed to determine if control coefficients were desirable and to define various error metrics quantitatively. The team iterated through this process multiple times until an optimized design was achieved. The 2022 aircraft was tested rigorously, sporting an average flight test time of over 5 minutes while only averaging 30 seconds per flight in manual mode. Furthermore, endurance testing proved that the aircraft can fly up to 30 minutes in a single mission. Waypoint performance was evaluated throughout the testing process until an optimal trade-off between aircraft stability and maneuverability was reached. This was primarily conducted post-flight, using various flight evaluation tools such as Plot Juggler. Overall, the aircraft attempted to reach 555 waypoints and successfully hit 532 of those points, resulting in a success rate around 96%. Furthermore, the average miss distance was 30 feet for all the waypoints, with 150 of them coming within 10 feet. Similar testing methods were used for obstacle avoidance, and obstacles performance was measured both in simulation and during flight tests. In total, 123 static obstacles were tested in real time, and 111 of these were successfully avoided. The average avoidance distance from the nearest point of the obstacle was 16 feet. Dynamic obstacle avoidance was not tested and will not be implemented in this year's aircraft.
A GoPro Hero 10 capturing 23 megapixel images at 60 frames per second allows us to achieve an average of 45 by 45 pixel cropped images for targets ranging from 1 to 2 feet in width. A brushless motor gimbal keeps the camera pointing straight down. This, along with GoPro's built-in stabilization algorithm, reduces the effects of motion blur to a minimum. We performed several tests, both on a custom-built drone and our fixed-wing aircraft, at different altitudes and velocities to arrive at these results. To test our deep learning models and image processing algorithms, we curated several test datasets in a mixture of different conditions, including weather and terrain. Each dataset includes hundreds of frames and roughly 70 handmade targets. Additionally, we procedurally modified the resolution of the images to benchmark our system's performance at different extremes. Annotating was performed in a semi-automated fashion, where our models would make their predictions and we would manually correct their mistakes. Our final system reaches an 83.3 mean average precision for target detection and shape classification, and the accuracy is listed here for other target properties. To test the accuracy of our localization algorithm, we measured the GPS locations of 53 targets and compared these values to our algorithm's predictions, achieving an average localization error of 47 feet. However, we have further tested our system in a custom-built simulation where we measure our system's resilience to internal errors, such as GPS inaccuracies and out-of-sync telemetry and camera frames. Our image stitching system was tested in 8 real flights, achieving an average coverage of 71%. However, despite the incomplete coverage, only an average of 4 minor stitching errors were found in the resulting maps.
Full mission tests were executed in order to verify the integration of systems in an end-to-end regime. To best replicate a competition atmosphere, the team randomly generated a series of logical obstacles and accompanying waypoints. These were then fed into the RRT Dubin's pathfinding algorithm, which outputted an optimal route for the aircraft to fly. Targets were placed in a simulated search zone, and their approximate GPS coordinates were noted. The team operated under a simulated timed competition environment to iron out inefficiencies in setup. The team was then able to complete 6 full missions, including waypoint following, obstacle avoidance, and all related ODLC tasks. During these exercises, valuable performance data was collected to accurately estimate a competition score. The team was able to validate all of the planned tasks. Images of high enough quality for image processing were achieved, over 95% of waypoints were hit, and 90%+ of obstacles were avoided. Most importantly, 0 safety incidents were produced throughout the testing phase. One major flaw identified in our system was an error with auto takeoff due to unhealthy airspeed data caused by strong crosswinds. This problem was remedied on a software and hardware level. An estimated mission score was derived from competition guidelines and UAS performance in testing. PART expects to meet all 10 points in the timeline and obstacle avoidance categories. ODLC is a challenging task, and a conservative evaluation resulted in 24 of 30 points. Autonomous flight and waypoint following is predicted to result in 9 points. Mapping has also posed a challenge, so 5 points will likely be deducted, and all airdrop points will be lost as the task is not being attempted. Finally, Purdue anticipates full points in operational excellence for a total score of 68 of 100 in the mission demonstration. The 2022 UAV was developed as a product of thorough research iterative testing in modern manufacturing, and the team expects the score to reflect as such.